120. I worked hard. Too hard. I worked hard. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, my dear friends. My name is Muhammad Numan. How are you, my dear friends? I hope you will be fine. Welcome to Advanced English Grammar. Today we are going to discuss a new topic, and that is the causative verb. In this video we will see the definition and the structure of the causative verb. The causative verb is the type of the verb. And in this video we will discuss only three causative verbs, which are make, have, and got. So let's talk about the definition of the causative verb. Causative has derived from the cause, which means the reason. Definition: a subject forces another subject to perform an action on his behalf. When one person causes another person, we use over there the causative verbs. The causative verb is used to express the idea that one person causes another person to do something. We use the causative verbs. The first causative verb is the make. We use the verb make is used to force another person to do something. We use this causative verb. For example, I love, this is a simple statement, this is a simple example, simple sentence. We do the action. But whenever someone else does the action, and we are the cause of that, we use the causative verb. He himself or herself doesn't do that action. We are forcing that person to perform that action. We use the causative verb. For example, I made you laugh. Now you can see subject I, verb, subject plus verb. In this situation, in this sentence, the subject, it doesn't do any action. It forces this verb, this subject, to do something. And this verb will change, this verb is a causative verb. It will change according to the tense. But if we see to this sentence, this verb, it will not change according to the tense. Okay? In this sentence, this is the causative verb. He does the action, but causes, I cause this action, this subject. We use the causative verb. I made you laugh. This is the simple past sentence. First simple sentence, okay? Okay, another sentence, the present indefinite, we will take the example from that. I make you eat. I made you eat. In all the tenses, you can use the causative verbs. It depends on the situation. You can also say, I make you laugh. I am making you laugh. He is making you laugh. She is making you laugh. I have made you laugh. I have already made you love. I will be making you love. I will make you love. With all the tenses, we can use the causative verbs. Okay? I make you eat. I made you eat. We use there this causative verb. Now let's talk about the difference between make, get, and have. First, we have to talk about get. Sorry, have. Have we use when we request to someone to do something. It is used whenever we are going to hire someone to do something. When we are requesting someone to do something, we use there the verb have. For example, I hate the past tense. I hate my brother carry my suitcase. You can also say, I have my brother carry my suitcase. And in other words, I have requested. I requested my brother carry my suitcase. We use there the causative verb have. And let me tell you one thing. I made my brother carry my suitcase. I made you love. In these two sentences, the two will not be used. You cannot say, I made you to love. Not at all. You cannot use to after the subject. In this situation also, I made my brother to carry. Not at all. You cannot write to here, my suitcase, right? And in this situation, we are requesting someone to do something. In the last example, got, we will talk about got, how we will use when we are going to convince someone to do something. The word got is used when one person convince another person to do something, we use the verb, the causative verb, got. For example, I got my brother to carry my suitcase. Now, let me tell you one thing here. After I got my brother to, the to will be used here with the verb. My suitcase. But whenever there is no subject available in the sentence, after that, what will be the structure? I have the wall repaired. The third form of the word will be used in the sentence, in the last. Okay, I got my shoes polished. The people were made to wait outside. As we said, as I told you before, that we are not using to with mad, but in the passive voice sentence we can use the word to, right? This is the passive voice sentence. The people were made to wait outside. So it was our today class about these three causative verbs. Again, I'm going to say here, we use the causative verb is used to express the idea that one person causes another person to do something. We may request from someone, we may convince someone, or we may request someone to do something. We use there the causative verb. In this situation, I made you, you itself do not do some action, but I'm going to compel you. The obligation is here. I'm going to force on you to do that action. We use there the verb, the causative verbs. In this situation, the force is available. Have the request, and here God, we convince, we hire, we request someone We convince someone to do something. We use there these three verbs. Inshallah, in the next video, we will talk about the next causative verb, and that will be lit. How we will use the word lit in different sentences. So it was our today class. Let me tell you about my channel. My channel name is Spread the Useful Knowledge. Share these videos to your friends and relatives through WhatsApp, Messenger, and Facebook. That would be very kind of you. And inshallah, when they will come, we will complete the grammar section. After this, we will talk about the literature, the fundamentals, the basics of the literature. So do subscribe our channel. The name of our channel is Spread the Useful Knowledge. Share these videos throughout the world. Thanks a lot of you. Thanks, Amanda.